Everybody, it's Cinnamon Cooney, your art Sherpa, and joining us today are both my husband, John, who is Sherpa tracking. He's going to be following me on one of our three cameras, because our fourth camera is being used for Marion, who is our American Sign Language interpreter today. So everybody say hi, Marion.
Hi, Marion.
Hi, Marion. And she'll say hi back, so that's pretty cool. My job, as always, when Marion is here, is not to get so enchanted by what she's doing that I just stop teaching and watch her. Mm-hmm. We're going to be painting the rainbow birch trees today. I'm going to guide you through every step of this lesson. We're doing it in acrylic paint. Materials list is in the description, as always, including a link to the painting so that you can see the finished painting if you need to print it out to paint along. And, of course, I posted these up on Facebook, and I put them around. So you can find it somewhere to get printed out. That can help you when you're painting to see the finished painting as you're going. Mm-hmm. Today, we're going to actually feature Karen, aren't we, from the album Sigh?
Yeah.
Yes. We have one of our very own artists who's a musician, and she's given us permission to feature her album throughout this episode. So if you're loving it, I also put a link to that in the description below. She didn't ask me to. I just really liked it. I thought you might want to know where it was. That's all that happened. Be doing this on a 16 by 20 canvas and using equipment for acrylic. I'll cover that as we go. The first thing I want to do is move this over. Try not to knock everything down. And open my package of economy 16 by 20 canvases. I often talk about this at the beginning of a lesson that I get economy packs of canvas. This is what I mean. I got this particular economy pack at the lobby where you hobby.
Mm-hmm.
Because I was in there for something else. So they do two packs. I'm going to make a mess over here in the corner. This canvas is pre-gessoed, so you should not need to gesso it again. However, if you find that it's resisting the paint, sometimes they coat it with another coating after gesso that may be plastic. Mm-hmm. And you just fix that by hitting it with another coat of cheap gesso. If you find, like, I can't paint on this canvas, it's like I'm painting on plastic, that's what happened. It's not you. It's the manufacturing.
Yeah. Now, can sanding help that at all?
Well, yeah. Anytime you would abrade a surface, it helps prepare it for acrylic paint. So sanding can help. Mm. But it's very easy to. You can get economy gesso and.
Just put a little gesso on there and it's just done, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
We're going to be putting some very important wishes on our canvas today. Yeah. We always like to do wishes. I'm using watercolor pencil. So if you're wishing on your canvases too, putting your intentions or hopes or wishes, watercolor pencil or kid's chalk, because it'll disappear into the paint. Mm-hmm. If you used a regular pencil, it would show through. And today, we're going to take a deep breath. Let it out. And we're going to just relax, because this is Saturday, and Saturday should be an easier day.
Yeah.
So we're going to just take it down. We're going to relax. And we're going to just allow, we're going to be inclusive of ourself, inclusive of other people, and just easy and allowing,
mm-hmm.
right in this safe space. This is safe painting space, because here you are in charge. So, John, would you like to share the wishes?
We have a lot of wishes today.
We do. We have some I texted you.
We do. I'm actually cutting and pasting some of the ones from the community in so I can get back over there to it.
Okay.
So, the wishes from you, I'm going to slide them over. My screen's so big and it's so far away.
Well, I know one.
Okay, go right ahead.
We have a wish. Janine sent this over for a young woman named Myra. She is missing.
Oh, yeah.
She's not a child, but she is a young woman, and her family's worried. Everyone is worried. So I want us all to put energy into the universe that she returns home safe and okay. That's mm-hmm. just all we want, is that she gets to come home safe and okay.
Yeah.
Turns home safe and okay. All right. Have you found your wishes?
Oh, yeah. There's a lot. I'm just trying to capture them all, actually. So, Esmeralda has a wish for safe travels, health, and financial stability.
Ooh, that's a good wish. I like that set of wishes. Health, travel, safe travel, and financial stability. I love.
Yeah, we're going to put some wishes in there for Kirsten, and who's really struggling, needs light and love.
Light and love to Kirsten.
And let's and wish for handicap access for members who need that.
You know, yeah, that is just such an easy thing to do, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's such a simple thing to have that. So I definitely wish to see more and more and more handicap access in the world. And I have come to, because that's touched my life, I've come to notice when it's missing.
Yeah.
And I realize that somebody couldn't get to this store, or they couldn't get to this space, or the aisles are just too narrow. They're just not thought out. Inclusion is so important. Inclusion is free. Inclusion is easy, and it makes the world so much better that I can't imagine why we don't do it in everything we do.
And we've got so many wishes coming in right now. I'm going to try to condense these down into just a couple and let our light keepers catch the rest for us.
That's true, because if you see a wish that speaks to you at home, you can put that in your canvas.
Yeah, we
that's all it takes to be a light keeper.
We're going to try to get to all of them we can.
Just be there for other people and be helpful, and that's what you're doing. You're keeping that light.
So we're gonna wish for an end of child abuse.
Oh, let's end that.
That's a good wish. And there's a lot of people wishing for children to do well and be healthy and happy. So let's put a big wish for children.
I know we have a young boy who is sick at home. We're going to wish him well.
Mm-hmm.
He's recovering. I don't have the name. I don't know if that got texted. Did you see that go by?
I've got really like 10 or 12 here that I've been trying to cut and paste in.
Yeah.
So there's a lot that we're trying to capture today. But a lot of kids that are, visiting, the loss of loved ones. They're visiting grandparents who are passing or in pain. And
just lots of love. It's so hard to be little.
Yeah. So,
yeah.
And we'll wish for less anger.
Yes, just less anger in ourselves, right? And less anger in the world.
Yep.
Because that will make things better. Anger is a wonderful tool when you use it intentionally. It's just when it takes hold of you.
Yeah.
When you don't need it. A good anger can be really helpful, but an anger that gets a hold of you when you're not planning for it can sidetrack your day in a way you don't want. So I wish that for everyone. A good happy relationship to anger. What a weird idea, right?
Yeah.
But yes, a good one. And my personal wish again is inclusion.
Inclusion, yeah.
Inclusion. That is the most powerful word. I would love to see worldwide inclusion. Just a free, easy thing that we can do.
Yeah. So I think that's a good place to bring it in.
Today we're painting. Now I'm painting with pro paints. I paint with like golden. I have some Liquitex over here. But listen, what you should be painting with is just the best paint that your budget allows, right? Don't make your budget hurt. That's not necessary in creativity. You just paint with the best paint that your budget allows. If you see a sale and you can upgrade your paint, that's always fun. But never, never hurt your pocketbook, because it's just paint. Right, John?
Yeah, absolutely.
All right.
Paint within your budget.
Paint within your budget. So we've got wonderful rainbow colors today. We have Cad Red Medium. You can save some money if you get Hue. And in all of the under-probe paints, it's always Hue. Cad Orange Hue, Orange Medium, right there, Cad Orange. Cad Yellow Medium. Again, in all the cadmiums, you can save money by buying Hue. We have Phthalo Green. We have Phthalo Blue. We have Dioxazine Purple and Titanium White and Mars Black.
And you're going to have to slide that.
I will.
Yeah, you have to keep an eye out there.
Where do you need me to have this? Ooh. How's that?
Your sippy. Sippy's in the way.
Oh, you know what? Oh, I'm going. All right, I've got to go the other way. Guys, we'll get it worked out. We've got time. This is our Saturday. This is our sacred painting space. We have time. Now, down the road, we're going to make sure that... wow, I just can't. How's that?
Good.
It's niched. It's found its niche. I'm going to get a nice... I'm going to get my Goldilocks, my favorite brush. This is Simply Simmons number 10, and this is an extra firm filament. Wherever you are, whatever brushes you're painting with, check that the filament on your brush is not soft enough for makeup. It's got to be a little too firm for makeup, but not so firm it would remove rust from your car, kind of in between there. I'm going to moisten my brush, but not soak it. And I'm going to start out with my rainbow. And my rainbow is a lot of fun, right? Because a rainbow always goes in the same pattern. But I'm going to do a weird little trick here. I'm going to kind of surprise you. I'm going to get a scotch of my blue. And you're like, wait, what? I'm going to get a scotch, a smidge, the smallest little touch of blue. And I'm going to bring it over to my CAD. And the reason I'm doing that is I want my first... little band behind my trees to be just a little darker than pure CAD, so I can put my pure CAD there to lighten it. And I'm going to be doing about a hand's width wide. I hear Miss Karen singing. About a hand's width wide of this strip going down. All right. So all I'm doing is just, you know, tinting. Right, a little bit. I still want it to be clearly red. So if it turns into a gray mess, then all that's happened is that you've just added a little too much blue. You're also going to notice that I stay way outside. I don't go in the center of my paint and scoop.
Hey, Cinnamon.
Yeah.
Can you look up at the camera for me for a minute? We're gonna take just a moment. I'm gonna try to reconnect with Marion. Because our connection is a little rough, so hold on just a second.
Okay, I hang out with my peeps. We'll paint. We'll play some Karen.
Yeah, she's playing in the background. I'll pull it up a second. Hold on just a second here, and I'm gonna reconnect.
I thought I was gonna have a dancing.
You thought you were. Okay. Oh my gosh, such a better connection. Bing. So.
Thank you guys for your patience. You know, I think it's amazing that we have a space that we can do this, that we can real-time translate an episode like this. But there are always some technical issues, and I'm just grateful that it's possible. So I'm continuing to paint this down. I'm still watching my paint management, working from the outside of my paint. My brush strokes are kind of this funny little diagonal today. And that's because that's okay. Smidge, scotch. Imagine that the blue is the hottest chili pepper in the world. That's about how much you want to add to your red.
Yeah.
It's just a small amount. Ooh, almost got in the purple. That would have been interesting. Maybe it would have been a happy accident. Happy accident. So, here I go. Happy accident. Painting along. Actually, this canvas is taking paint really well.
Is it?
Yeah. And I'm just going to come over and mix a little of this orange into the side of my red here. Mm-hmm. You see me just doing that?
I do.
Coming along there. And right between these two seams, maybe I'll zoom in. Should I zoom in? We are working to orient the studio left, guys. It's just we're going to have a couple of days in a row where we're not doing any filming to do it because we have to take it all down.
Yeah.
So I'm just blending these two seams. Does not need to be perfect because we're going to have trees in front of it. This painting is just about having a nice Saturday, right? You don't have to worry about it too much. Little red into my orange. Just a little bit. And I'm just enjoying putting this in. It's fun for me. I like rainbows. I always have since I was a kid.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the rainbow is so meaningful to people. And I think it has a special meaning to artists because it has all the paint colors.
Yeah.
You know, and I always look at them and I think about how every color has a purpose. That the rainbow would be so much more meaningless if it was missing a color. And then I wonder about the colors that I can't see and if the rainbow would be even more spectacular if I could see more colors.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, this is a weird thing. John hears me talk about these things philosophically all the time. I rinse out my brush a little bit. Because it's just loaded a little too much red, and I'm going to come and pull a little more orange. And as I'm coming here towards the center, my orange is getting brighter. And as I'm coming along, so much fun. Having a great time painting this in. Deep breath. Relax. It's just paint. If you're finding yourself getting stressed at home, it's just paint, you know. If you're painting the canvas, I'm going to show an area. I'm going to zoom in just to help you troubleshoot at home. I'm going to zoom in here. If you're painting and paint isn't getting on this, a couple things can be happening. You might not have enough paint on your brush. I know that seems silly, but that's a thing that can happen to you. You might not have enough moisture on your brush. You might have let your brush get too dry and you're actually dry brushing instead of painting. Or the filament on your brush may be too soft.
Ah, okay.
Notice how in none of those explanations is it that you can't paint.
Right.
I think that's the hardest thing for people to realize because when they have any trouble, they're just like, oh, well, it's me. I'm going to get some yellow. And a little orange is tinting it. And I'm going to come right here and enjoy blending that yellow in. It's so much fun.
So is this a two-hoot painting?
I'd say this is two-hoot.
Two hoots?
This is two-hoot. Not that any of it is difficult, but it has a lot of layers.
Mm-hmm.
Right, because we've got to get the rainbow in, and then there's some work getting the birch trees in, and then we still have the leaves and grass. So
yeah.
Everything inside of it is about a one-hoot difficulty. There's just a lot more going on.
Gotcha.
Sometimes when I look at my hoot rating, I ask myself, how long does it take to do the painting?
Ah, yeah.
Right? Not just the skills inside of it, but how long does the painting itself take to complete? I'm going to rinse out my brush just a little bit, and I may put some more yellow out. I like that when you see on these golden tubes, when you see CP, that means cadmium pigment. When they're using real cadmium pigment, they'll tell you, and that's because you should never eat cadmium. It's poisonous.
Yes.
Yes. But here's my theory. You should never eat paint. Because I imagine none of it is good for you. As food.
No.
I feel it's probably all a little risky. I'm pulling some just yellow here, just right here. Just to bleed the seam. Right here, I'm just making sure there's just a pure run of yellow before I get into my green. It'll make a nicer blend. Because if you're on the quest, green and orange are close to being complements on the color wheel. And would make a gray color. So we want bright colors.
So one of our moderators, Ethel, has a question.
Hi, Ethel.
She wants to know.
I'm so excited today.
When I blend, I tend to blend right over colors. Any advice?
Right over colors.
I think that's over blend.
Over blend.
I think is what's over happening.
Yeah, that, you know what? That happens to everybody. There's a stage, and that's about learning to relax and see the painterliness of it and go, yes, that's good. Because when you're very new, you get very uptight, and you're looking for a perfect seam, a seam with no ragged edges, a seam that, you know, is invisible. And that really isn't the goal here. Right? I think that's sometimes the attraction of oil painting, because you could blend and blend and blend. Blend and blend and blend and blend. And then blend some more.
Mm-hmm.
There's just a never-ending... there's the never-ending story. There's the never-ending blending.
Now,
I've got this yellow and green I'm blending here. I've added a little yellow to my green.
So if you're new to us, right? If you're new here...
If you're new here, hello. I'm so glad you're painting today.
Yes.
Welcome, welcome.
And we do broadcasts live 3 times a week. Right?
Yes, we do, and we leave them up.
Yep. Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays.
I just grabbed some pure green, and I'm coming down. Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays, 3 times a week with this beautiful group of people who shows up and brings such positive energy to the room.
Yes.
You just cannot imagine how blessed we are over in painting. Best viewing community on YouTube.
Absolutely. And you guys can help us by sharing and subscribing and letting others know and share the paintings.
Yes, that is a fantastic way. And a new way you can help us is we have a fan-contributed closed captioning enabled.
Oh,
and we've had someone actually do that for Be the Light.
Which was beautiful.
It was incredible. She closed captioned the entire episode. And so now that is available to so many more people. And that helps with our inclusion goal. Because one of our main goals is to include people. So really excited about that. So if you're a fast typer, that's something that you can do. I'm not a fast typer. I'm adding a little blue to my phthalo green. And I'm just coming along here. Just sort of fun for me to do. I love this painting. This is such a fun painting for me. Just painting with you guys on a Saturday, but I'm also having a nice relax myself. Just a nice relax myself.
Now, here's a question coming in for color mixing.
I'm so thrilled to answer any color mixing questions.
Can I use primary yellow mixed with cad yellow light hue?
Can you? Yeah, you could mix a primary yellow with cad yellow light hue. But what's the goal? I mean, those two things would mix, but what would the goal be? To make a different yellow?
I guess.
That would be what I would need to understand is what's the goal of the mix?
Right.
Because the mix might have a goal, and I'm going to pull some just blue now. Some just phthalo blue. Some just, this is so fun for me. I love this. Just phthalo blue. Just the phthalo blue coming down. So much fun. It's going to be so pretty when it's done. So cheerful when you look at it. You'll just feel your little heart be happier, and a little happier.
We have a great community out on our website of people sharing their artwork,
mm-hmm.
talking about their journeys.
We may play an art game on our art break today, and that would be a place you could post your results.
That's true.
Okay. I have my sippy sippy. I love my sippy sippy. It's coffee today. And I'm going to pull some purple. I've added a little blue to it. And I might add, in this case, a little bit of white because the purple is so dark. And I want it to show up as purple. Clearly.
Clearly.
Clearly purple. Because sometimes purple is the darkest color on the color wheel. And it can, against other colors, sometimes read as black. So in this case, you may have to, if you have a very dark purple, you may have to add a little white just to make sure that its purpleness is represented.
Now, if you don't, I think that the goal of the question earlier was to get to the color of yellow that you're using.
Oh, to get to the color of yellow I'm using. I would probably primary yellow would be closer to cad yellow medium than cad yellow light. Cad yellow light has got a little green tone to it. So you'd want something that was warmer, and primary yellow would be just slightly warmer than cad yellow light. Cad yellow medium has got a little teeny tiny amount of red to it. It's got a warm tone to it. So that would be what's happening there. So just probably your primary yellow.
Now, you're using your number 10?
I'm using my number 10 Simply Simmons Extra Firm Filament. It's a bright. I love brights. I love Filberts. They're all wonderful brushes. A bright is a workhorse. I don't know how to explain it other than that. It's a workhorse in your brush toolkit.
Yeah.
It just gives you a good, firm, controlled result. So I haven't been that particular here. Right, here we go. How's that?
That looks really good.
See a nice little up close of it all. It's just a nice little rainbow that we've made. I know kids love doing this because they just in general love making the rainbow.
Yeah.
They just in general love making the rainbow. This is a good time to change out your water. Clean water is excellent for this project. Now, right here, in almost the exact center point where the yellow and the orange are kind of bled together, I'm going to take another bright, and this one is a number 8, but you could do your number 10 again. And on a very, very dry brush, I'm going to take a tiny amount of yellow over to my white. I want this to be mostly white. Just not perfectly white. And I want the brush to be dry. I'm going to come not quite. So if this is the center of the center, center this way and center this way, center vertically and horizontally, I'm going to come up just a little bit from that. And I'm going to, on a very dry brush, if you have to wipe it off on a towel, wipe it off on a towel, radiate out some light rays. Now, if your canvas isn't dry, you may need to dry it with a hairdryer.
Yep.
Mine just is pretty dry, so I'm going to get away with it. And I'm just radiating it out. It's not perfect white. It's not totally white. There's a little tint of yellow to it. But it's very, very light. And I'm just going to do that while I'm here, radiating out these light rays. Radiating out these light rays. We've done the circle where we've painted a circle out to radiate light.
Mm-hmm.
This is just a different way we can do that. I thought it'd be a nice twist technique that I could show you. That one had a nice little bit of yellow on it. Just coming in. Try to think. If you have trouble doing, try to imagine that it's a clock.
Yeah.
That's a good way to help you radiate out easily. I'm not taking my radiation too far over into my blue and purple. I'm letting it be stronger over in my warmer colors. Can you guys see that?
Yeah, I think they can.
Just dry brushing. Dry brushing allows the canvas underneath to show through. Right? So all that color, if you can see that out the up-close cam. I don't know if John's doing any up-close.
I am sometimes.
Sometimes? I don't know if it's... Is it showing what we need it to show?
Yes.
Okay, so you can kind of see how much of the canvas is showing through. And this is a good time to dry your canvas. I'm going to dry mine with a hairdryer. If you're painting craft paint, move back a little bit and get the temperature down, because temperature affects acrylic paint greatly, and heat can cause color shift, which means it darkens.
So, sorry guys, I've been juggling all of the buttons back here, and I really appreciate all our community joining us today. So, we have a lot of moderators out there today. I've seen Kim Sim and Mona, and I think I saw Bonnie earlier, and of course the oh look, there's Janie, and I'm gonna keep scrolling up. So I think I saw Jane earlier too. So I really appreciate all you guys coming and hanging out with this great audience. So thank you guys all for coming and hanging out with us. And pull Cinnamon back up.
Hi everybody. Just gotta make sure the paint's dry sometimes. So now, what I do is I'm going to start putting in the trees. Things I'd like to say about trees to you is that they must be thicker at the bottom of your canvas, right? And then as you go up, they're going to get thinner. Trees get skinnier as they get older. Totally unfair fact of nature. Trees get skinnier the older they get. The further they grow out, the skinnier they are. So the more and up and up and up you go, the more it needs to be skinny. And as we put in branches, those would have to be skinnier than the trunk that they're connected to. We're going to do several sizes of trees because in our forest, trees come in all shapes and sizes. And I'm going to do 7 trees because that's very significant and meaningful to me. Because it is.
Oh, I just saw Angela.
Hi, Angela.
The other half of your loony.
I think she's got a 2 o'clock today. She's teaching something fabulous at 2. Who's going?
I think we'll probably go.
We'll probably go. No, we have to eat with your sister.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
We're eating with Sarah.
We'll catch
today,
you on the
Angela.
Reruns.
I'm going to catch you on the replay.
We'll catch you on the replays.
All right. So I've got my brush loaded up with gray. I've made a mid-tone gray. It's not a dark gray, and it's not a very light gray. All right. I'm going to come up on the edge of my brush from the bottom. And the first thing I like to do is sort of plan my trees I'm coming up. Give myself a little line to anchor to, right? So once I have that in, it's pretty easy for me to come and make a parallel line on the side that's coming in and it's joining up at the top. So that's about 1 inch apart and maybe a little half inch over. I'm gonna make another line. And it's getting skinnier as it goes up. Skinnier, skinnier, skinnier. So the point that I'm trying to get, and I'm going to paint that all in all gray, is that it must be thicker down here and skinnier up here. And I think we've accomplished that. The other thing I like to do is sort of have my tree not be perfect.
Mm-hmm.
It hasn't grown perfectly straight. Weather and life has bent it. It has personality. Has a little personality, has a little bit of fun about it. How is everyone liking the music today?
Well, they've been all asking about it. Is this the music we got in the mail?
This is the music that we got in the mail. And if you want to know more, I found it. I tracked it down on Amazon, like I am known to do, and I included the link.
Excellent.
Because I'm like that. So that's just down in the description. So if you're like, this is just what I got to have jamming in my studio,
mm-hmm.
which now I do have jamming in my studio, you know where to get it. I'm going to come over to the right here, and I'm gonna make a friend for this tree. This tree isn't alone in the forest, right? This tree has this younger friend right here. I'm going to plant my little seed at the bottom. I'm going to wander up, not being perfect. Just giving myself a guideline. Just a little friend. Every time you paint your forest, it may be a little bit different. And this is a pretty skinny one, so I'm trying to do this all in a single brush stroke. I may grab a smaller bright, just slightly smaller. I think I'm gonna grab an 8, just to help me out a little bit. Mid gray. So what's Angela up today? What's she doing in the chat?
Oh, there was some shenanigans earlier. I'm gonna
She's a shenanigan creator.
They were joking around.
She makes the shenanigans. She cracks me up. All right. I've got that little branch right there. That branch. It's a tree. It's a whole tree. Maybe it's like offended that its friends sometimes call it a little branch. But it's a whole tree. And then next to this tree will be another little friend. He'll be slightly bigger. And also apparently a boy. Tell inner narratives about your paintings. I wholly recommend that. When you have an inner story about your painting, no matter what you're painting, it creates a more full and complete world. Mm-hmm. Also, as part of what helps you relax, take a deep breath. Anytime you're feeling any anxiety, just breathe in the good. Breathe out that bad. Breathe in that good. All the good in your life. All the things that you like. Breathe out the bad. Things that are causing you any anxiety or stress, just let those go. Put all the good into your rainbow forest here. When you hang it on the wall, you'll look at it and you'll feel all those good feelings coming in strong. I'm going to paint another mother kind of tree right here. Strong tree. Another mother tree. Come over here. All right, come out a little bit. Are the up-close camera helping at all today?
I think so.
Oh, I've got to get it off Marion. That's what it is. There you go. I think I'm off Marion. Am I off Marion?
I think so.
Okay. There mostly. You go. Mostly off Marion. So coming up here, planting this gorgeous tree. Speaking of inclusion, I had a thought that if, you know, one of the things that's lovely about painting is if one feels not included, if you're a person who feels excluded, painting is incredibly healing for that. It's a great place to put that stress into. It's very stressful to not be included and accepted.
Mm-hmm.
Causes a great deal of anxiety. Not just in the teen years. I feel like that goes on into adulthood.
Yeah.
Right. Goes on into adulthood. And the nice thing about you and your canvas is you can accept each other. You can accept each other. And one of the things that I love about our group is our group is inclusive.
Oh, yeah.
Really open-hearted.
Now, how do you decide on the size of the trees?
Well, whimsically is the honest, most truthful answer. I generally plant a seed, which is just my way of making a brushstroke, making a decision, right? So when I first designed this painting, I made this tree first. And then I just started telling my story about who else was there. I try to keep in mind balance in my composition. Make sure that I'm not cloning or repeating all of my shapes, right? Because we don't want to be clones. You know, you don't want to be a clone. You want to be yourself, the unique, beautiful person that you are. Your trees are like that. I assume my trees want the same things on the canvas. They have the same hopes and dreams that I have.
Yeah.
It's a weird world, but it is. Painting is a very whimsical activity. It should be, anyways.
Yeah.
It can be very serious, too, if you enjoy seriousness.
You could make some serious trees.
You could make some serious trees.
Yep.
Because we've talked about this before. Design theory, art theory, it's turtles all the way down.
It is.
It just never ends. So I'm just making sure I have nice, good coverage on my tree. It doesn't have to be perfect. So now I've got this side of my forest planted. I'm going to come over and plant some trees on this side of my forest. There we go. That's actually perfect placement for the up-close cam.
Hey.
And again, we're going to be orienting the studio left, which should help with some of the visibility. And I'm going to stretch out my neck so I can look left a little better. So tree is coming up, it's coming up, and then maybe it's going to wander a little bit to the left, just a little bit. It's leaned, There was a storm, maybe. I'm going to bring this up. I'm always running my line parallel, but I'm also trying to converge. I'm trying to bring this closer together. And that's what gives my nice tree trunk shape. I've seen you guys do several of these birch tree paintings big. Big. And I think they look fantastic. I can't imagine how gorgeous it is to look at a big... Can you imagine this on a big 4860 canvas, John?
Mm-hmm.
How pleasant that would be to stare at. Contemplative, meditative even. Back in every brushstroke.
Yeah.
Back in every moment of calm. Hopefully everyone is finding their moments of calm today.
Yeah.
We're going to call these the twins. They're going to be kind of similar in size. Maybe their seed pods fell at the same time. And they came up in the forest, drinking from the same rainfall, under the same patch of sunlight, and they grew. And they're each individuals, but they're very similar. Same fertile soil, where their seed pods fell.
Mm-hmm.
See, that's really fun. Aren't you relaxed?
I'm very relaxed.
Aren't you relaxed? The music today, this painting today... Love the messaging today. I love when we open up our hearts and include more people,
mm-hmm.
and allow more variety into our lives. I think that's so important. So important.
Yeah.
I'm going to come up here. This is the last one. This one's going to be kind of like a skinny little rebel. Skinny little rebel. This tree has lots of personality, though. Does its own way. Look how the forest needs so many different kinds of trees to feel like a beautiful forest. Waxing philosophically here, John.
I hear you. So... Flame was...
Hi, Flame.
She wanted to know when we're going to do some black light butterflies.
Dude, we do need to do some black light butterflies, don't we?
Mm-hmm.
Black light butterflies. That would be really fun.
That would be.
Tuesday?
Yeah.
We could do one Tuesday. I don't have anything on the calendar yet.
Oh, there you go. Well, we also have a request for frog.
A frog?
Like a tree black, frog.
Blacklight frog?
No, just a tree frog or something, you know, because I thought that'd be really cool, too. I was saving it for later.
You were saving it for later?
I think it'd be really cool to do, like, a really, you know, like an...
Well, I know we've got elephant on the request list that's been coming up a lot lately. I know we have some more blacklight paintings that are up on the list lately.
Yeah.
You know what? What we should do is we should do some polls and plan some next ones out is what we should do.
I think we need a blacklight painting.
We do need a blacklight paint. I just like going. Guys, it's so fun to paint blacklight. We've got some videos on how to convert your home studio to a blacklight studio. It's just a bulb at Home Depot. Super fun, though.
Yeah.
The paint is not expensive. Everybody's got a line of it. It's just fun.
Yeah.
Just fun.
I'm with Elizabeth. She thinks a green frog with orange feet. You know, I think that'd be pretty cool. Or maybe one of those, you know, those arrow frogs that are all red.
Oh, those are always so fun. So I'm going to rinse out my brush, like you do.
Like you do.
Like you do.
So it's, we're about 15 minutes before we need to give Marion a break.
Okay.
And I just want you to time that in there.
I'm going to try to time that in. Count me down.
I will.
Okay. So I'm going to put out some pure white, and I'm going to dry my brush out just a little bit.
Now, this is someplace that Lisa was really asking about help. She said that she can totally get the trunks in, but the branches elude her.
We'll go deep into branches when we go to branches. We'll do branches after the break, and we'll go deep.
Okay.
Deep branch work.
All right.
So you see how this light is coming around the center tree? That means it would be bending around this trunk a little bit. So for just this one tree, with a very dry brush. Can you see the load on this? It's just the tip of the brush. There's no moisture. Let's see if we can...
You can zoom in more.
I'm going to zoom in more and then move out of the way of... There we go. I can't move out of the way when you take it away.
I have it up there, too.
See, no, but I can't see where she is in relationship to. I can't make the adjustment. I'm going to very lightly... Very light pressure, dry brush, which causes it to be very kind of streaky. It allows it to do some of the work for me. Come on the outside of my tree, like this. Happily blending light in. This tree is bathed in glorious divine sunlight. It is loved. It is loved as it is. Does not need to be anything but what it is to be loved. It's just a happy love tree. And it feels the warm sunlight coming around it. And I'm just brushing that on. Way back in the summer of 69. Brushing the sunlight on. Enjoying that. Having fun. She knew where she was going. She was listening to my studio music. Putting loving light all around, wrapping around my tree. It's a long way. Maybe I might have to align there. Little bit. Coming in. Nice little define. So that one is like that. Now these three trees must be lit on their right hand sides. So I'm going to do just the right hand sides. Right, just the right hand sides. Same dry brush coming up. If you need to, one of the tricks I can do is sometimes I will line up the tree with my white and then come back and pull this white here. See that? And that can give me a nice neat edge. It's a thing you can do. You can just come and do the... Whoop, I think I moved my whole easel. Am I still on camera, John?
You are.
Sometimes I lean against my easel. It's funny.
I don't think your wheels are locked.
And no, my wheels are in no way locked. If I leaned hard, I'd go down. It'd be funny. It'd be super funny.
Live. Sherpa down.
Well, that'd be a gif, wouldn't it? In about 2 seconds. Actually, I'd make it into one, so...
You and Ian.
Yeah. Well, Ian's gif is like a real gif. He was on American Funniest Home Videos, like on TV. Just pulling that light across this tree. So it feels the light of the sun, and it knows the sun loves it. Trees know they are loved by the sun, and they have such love for the sun. Just pulling along, lighting up these trees. None of them is in the dark. Is everything okay, John?
Everything's going just fine.
Okay. Just pulling it along. How are we doing on our time?
Pretty good. We've got about 12 minutes.
There we go. Pulling it along. Just putting some light on our trees. I'm going to come up along here again. Just having some fun, making sure that there's a nice bright light on my tree. Having some fun. Pulling this along, lighting this tree. Just lighting my tree. On the street, you're so sure. You're indispensable. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Wonderful tree. Isn't it fun to light these trees?
It sure is.
It is for me. It's so relaxing. It's like, what are you going to do to work today? I'm going to go just really, really let go of the stress of my week and paint. That's what I'm going to do today with my husband and our friends live on a Saturday. We're just going to let it go. It's going to put down our burdens and have a little paint.
Yeah.
Put down our burdens and have a little paint. Now, when I come to the right side, I'm going to light the left side of the tree. See? We're learning a little bit about some storytelling that we can do in painting by just saying what side is highlighted. When you're painting from your photographs now, you might look at them a little differently and ask yourself what side of the tree would be highlighted. That'll help you tell that story better. Tell the story of these trees. This community of trees. Diverse, allowing trees. This tree doesn't tell that tree to straighten up.
You know, that's something you never see one tree tell another tree to straighten up.
No. You don't. You don't see one tree giving another tree grief for being the tree it is. You don't see a birch telling a pine to knock it off. Stop dropping those pine needles. It says thank you. Thank you for being who you are. You helped me. If they had a conversation, I think that's true. I have a lot of feelings about the conversations trees have in the woods. Painting this side. When we get to this tree, we'll take our break. And we'll play a little game. Mm-hmm. Let Mary and rest. Because it's very physically demanding to do what she's doing.
Yes.
She's telling this story. And I'm a chatterbox. So I can't imagine what that's like for her. All right. So we're pulling that there.
Are you still using your number 10?
No, remember I switched to my number 8.
Okay, this is number 8.
Number 8. Brush is dry. I'm just loading my paint. The dryness in my brush helps create the effect where it's sort of streaky. So I'm going to come on the left side here again, make my little highlight on my deep wood tree. Happy, happy deep wood tree. All right, just lighting this tree. Just having a good day. Singing our songs, painting our paintings, sipping our coffee. I might even get a fresh cup of coffee on the break during game.
Yeah.
See how it's going.
Now, if a lot of people are saying they're having trouble getting the number 10.
Yes.
Is the number 8 a good close?
Yes, the number 8 is a good close cousin, or the number 12. So the number 12, this is the size of the number 12.
Yeah, why don't you show that?
I'm going to show you guys all three so you can see them next to each other. I'm just going to need fresh water. They're all a little dirty. They're a little dirty, John. Dirty. Okay, so here you go. You can see the sizes. This is the number 10. This is a 12, and this is an 8.
And
it wouldn't hurt to have all three. And then grab their little friend. Here's a 4. It's quite useful. Look at that with the 4. But, you know, between the 4 and there is a 6. Here's a 6. There's the 6. Isn't that nice? And then guess what you could really do after that? There's number 2.
And then you can go into filberts.
And then you can do the same exact thing with the filberts. Pull these out. They're going to need a good wash. You need a wash. So that's what's fascinating to me, and that's what I like. We're going to let Marion break and have a rest. I'm going to get a fresh cup of coffee, hopefully with the help of John, and a fresh cup of water. And we're going to play an art game with you. Are you ready for art game?
Yep. I'm going to let Marion finish her. Bye-bye, Marion. she'll keep going. She'll just keep going. So when I see her pop back, we'll have her there.
Mm-hmm. So and we'll finish out the painting.
We'll finish out the painting.
So if you're at home, John, can you grab me a cup of coffee?
I can. And I also
I can.
I have our intermission, We can actually roll our intermission here.
We have an intermission?
Well, we have our three-minute break.
Oh, well, let's take the three-minute break. We'll make coffee and get fresh water, and then we'll come back and play art game.
Okay, so hold on just a
second. This is your first invitation to the art game.
I got to get my break loaded.
Okay.
So.
I'm saying something.
Are you?
Yeah.
What are you saying?
Well, I guess we'll start art game while you're... Art game goes like this. You're going to get five random words. Five. And you've got to doodle, paint, however you want to get it on canvas. It doesn't really matter. And the first rule of art game is no judging the doodle. No judge the doodle. You can't, right?
Yeah.
So five random words. You put it together any way you want to. No judge the doodle. You cannot spend more than 35 minutes.
No more than 35 minutes on the doodle.
Okay. No more than 35 minutes on the doodle. It's five things. 25 minutes.
25 minutes. Okay.
25 minutes.
So we should see some people posting doodles by the time they end the show.
You should post some doodles. Places you could post doodles are, of course, always, in Facebook on Angeluni or the Heart Party Facebook page. And then, of course, there's TheArtSherpa.com as a place for that. So random words. John knows the least about art, so I'm going to let John kick it off. Give us a random word, John. It has to be a thing.
Chameleon.
Chameleon. Hat. Your turn.
Rainbow.
Rainbow. Strawberry. We got one more, John. Finish this off.
Castle.
Chameleon, hat, rainbow, strawberry, castle.
I'm glad you remembered them.
I'm going to write them down.
Okay.
You put us on break and I'll write those down.
Okay. So we're going to make sure we got them out here.
And you pros, Stephanie and Mark and all the people of you guys who officially play art game, let them know. Don't let them get all mental about it.
So run them to me for again.
Chameleon, hat, rainbow, strawberry, castle. If you go over 25 minutes, nobody kicks you out of art game. We're just saying it's a personal goal. Try to keep it to 25. It's chameleon, so that you don't
hat,
go crazy.
Chameleon, hat, rainbow, strawberry, castle. Oh, man. All right. Okay. So you'll be back.
We'll be back.
Tell me you crave my affection. take me back to where it all began. Show me myself without the shell. When beauty was enough to save you from yourself.
If you're playing, it could be we just played it because we really like chameleon art.
We have buttons going. And you know what? I see over on my other screen that there is a Marion hanging out.
Is there a Marion?
Yeah. So
well, grab the kefir in the water for me, and then we'll bring Marion back.
Hold on, yeah. Let me.
I'm going to do this. I'm going to go up because I need to sit. I'm going to love my Elmer cup. Check that out.
See, look.
There's Marion. This is my unicorn cup. I really love it so much. I have heard they make a matching bowl. It's too much. It's very fond of Elmer. I love that my unicorn is named Elmer. I just think of the artist that made this cup. We're just waiting on some water. We're going to get started again. How are you doing? You keeping your weekend relaxed? We got to get better at taking it down. We got to get better at just putting down the burden and giving ourselves a little space in the day, just a little bit, where we don't commit to worrying or stress or anxiety. I love artwork for that. Can I have my cup of water, sweetheart? Because I can't paint without it. It's entirely my fault the cup is not here. Not his in any way. And he's being so patient with me about having to get it. Because I'm the one who didn't walk back with my cup of water. I want everyone to give Marion a hand. She's doing so good. All right. Thank you, darling. I appreciate it. Stunt hands. Here we go. Water's back. All right. So I'm going to take that same number 8, that same fabulous number 8. I'm going to get out of my own way here. Here, John, I need that screen, even though it's hard on everybody. I need it. It's not even an option because I have to adjust around Marion. So I'm going to load my brush with black paint, but it's very dry. I'm going to come along on the left-hand side of my canvas, on the left-hand side of my tree. I'm going to come along and very carefully on the edge of my brush come up. This is number 8, bright. Right? You're bright, may not be quite the same size as mine as an 8 unless it's a different brand. I'm going to pull straight out, dry brush this side of the tree. That also helps it get its sort of birchy effect. It's a nice quick way to get some birchy effect. Get some very dry paint here. Just creating that shadow, pulling the paint across, letting the little forest start to take shape. We're like really getting to know this album, aren't we, John?
Yeah, it's cool.
It's really cool. Anybody else in our community a musician? Because this is really amazing.
And this is Sigh by Karen, right?
Mm-hmm. And
Karen Walters.
Yeah, that is correct. You've got the CD right there.
Yeah, I'll go grab that real quick.
And I have the link to it in the description. I went and tracked it down. She didn't give it to me. She didn't ask for that or anything. She was just sharing some music with us. And I went and tracked it down on Amazon.
Yeah.
Because I like that. So just pulling this across. The trick is to keep this light and not too strong. Another thing that you might do is just in a couple places, put some dashes of black. You see that, John?
I do.
To help it feel like a birch tree. That's just a simple thing that you can do, dashing along. Doesn't take a lot of them to give it that feeling, but I think that little touch just pulls it together. John always loves it when I do finishing touches.
Yeah, I love it.
He's like, do you have any more finishing touches you could do? And I'm like, painting is done, John. Painting is over. We have finished. Coming along again, that left-hand side. And I'm going to do the same thing here that I did on this tree. I'm going to pull it in. Pulling it in. Breathing in the good things in my life. Breathing out the bad. Keeping my brush dry.
Yep.
Keeping my brush dry. And if you're worried, you can always dab it off on a towel. Not the kitchen towel you use for food, because don't eat paint. Don't chew on your brushes either. I learned that's a thing.
Yeah.
From the official people at Golden Paint. People have a real problem chewing on their brushes, and that can be a health hazard.
Don't do that.
Don't do that. So I'm officially publicly announcing for public safety, don't chew on your brush.
Yeah.
Don't let your cat chew on the brush either, especially if you paint with cadmium.
And we're going to send a hug out to Jackie.
Yeah.
Because she's feeling a little low today.
Oh, Jackie.
And she's with us, one of our community. So I've seen her out here before and having a low day. So we're just going to send some hugs.
Love,
and love,
Jackie. Hugs and love. Breathe in that good. Breathe out that bad.
Yep.
Tough to do. Making little dashes. Not going to do it everywhere because sometimes the little black paint I do on the tree is enough. But if I see a space that I need it, I'm going to put it in. If your brush is too big and it's giving you grief on your little tree, you can always switch to a smaller brush. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Just make what you're experiencing easy, enjoyable, and fun. I love doing this. I'm glad we're taking this forest a little further. And I'm glad we visited the forest again a little bit.
Yeah, I like the forest.
Well, I love my winter birch trees. I do. If you like these, we have another painting called Winter Birch Trees, all in kind of like white and Icelandic blue. But I just wanted something that was just a little warmer for the seasons.
Yeah.
You know. So now here on this center one, we're going to get really interesting.
Why is it going to be interesting?
It's going to be interesting because we don't want to outline the edges with black. We want to have a little kind of ziggy-zaggy story of shadow in the center of the tree.
Yeah.
Right? So what we're going to do is very lightly, super dry brush. I'm going to come here and staggering and very light. This is such light cat pressure. This is the wettest, angriest cat on YouTube. That's how lightly you want to... If you, this canvas were a wet, angry cat on YouTube, how lightly would you pet it? You just think about the craziest cat video you've ever seen on YouTube. Craziest cat video ever. That's how lightly you'd pet this cat. So we're just... We don't want to paint out our dovey gray. So this is a light hand moment. And it's fun to practice your light hand. How is your light hand today? And when you have that in, go ahead and give it some of the birch dots.
Yep.
Here and there. Here and there, not everywhere. Not necessary. Just give your tree some character. character for the tree. See, it just doesn't take a lot to put the tree in. Right?
Yeah.
And I bet you can guess what's going to happen next. I bet they can.
What's that?
Because they're so clever.
I can't guess.
You can't guess? We're going to now do exactly what we did over here on the left, on the right, but we're going to darken the right-hand side of the tree.
Okay, maybe I could have guessed that.
Yeah, I think you could have. You're pretty clever. You build cars.
Yeah, but
you figure
paint.
Out upholstery yourself. When are we going to get you painting?
I don't know. I push too many buttons.
You do. We got you coloring. We got him coloring.
It's true. I do.
He likes to color.
I like to color.
I like to color. Does anyone else like to color? I like to color as a family. I like to sit down at the kitchen table and we all take a sheet and some pretty good gel pens, which we've actually gone through. How many gel pens was that?
That's like, I don't know, 100
We got that thing of 100 gel pens and we all just sit down and color together as a family.
Yeah.
And the nice thing about the gel pens is they don't bleed through the paper.
No, they don't seem to.
Don't give me any trouble at all. Also, I don't know I would let the kids play with Copic markers. They're so expensive.
No.
Yeah.
I want to try out some more of those chameleon pens.
I'm so into the chameleon pens. I'm so into them. Chameleon should send us some pens. All your pens. Send them all. Send them all now. It's an emergency.
Lindy and I will play with them.
We will play with the pens. Just making sure that this tree has some shape and some shadow. I'm pulling it over. I'm having fun. If you're painting at home with your family and your friends, I hope you're taking the time to just laugh and have some fun. Don't take yourself seriously. Be supportive of each other because one of you in the group, and that's because there's always one, is going to have a meltdown and decide their painting isn't valid. You stop them in their tracks and make sure they know their painting is perfectly valid. Don't you let them do it.
And this is really an easy painting for anyone, yeah?
Anyone can do this painting. It has some layers, which is the only reason it qualifies as a two-hoot. Because we have the background, we have the trees, the branches, and then the leaves. Otherwise, it would be a one-hoot.
But you, if you were willing to put the time in, this is the first time. You could take this on.
You could take this on. You wouldn't see this like traditionally at a painting party just because it would be longer than they, you know, have hours to be open for.
Right.
But it's as easy. It's that easy.
Very simple.
Very. Beautifully designed, but simple. Barry, you are the best looking man that I have seen in quite a while. I'm sorry, she's getting to me. I'm digging it.
You're digging it. Yeah. Well, I'm going to take a cue from Flame and say, do please take the time to comment, like, and subscribe. It does help.
It does.
It lets YouTube know that you guys enjoy what we're doing.
Especially after the broadcast, too.
Yeah, it makes a big difference, the comments and the sharing. So
I think it's good for new people coming, checking out a thing, trying to decide if they think they've got it.
Yeah.
When they see you guys happy, they think to themselves, well, maybe. Maybe me. I love it when we get somebody who's like, they don't think they can, but because of every beautifulness you put into the world, they go, maybe me.
Yeah.
Love that.
I love the sharing of all your pictures. Really
yes,
appreciate
you.
That.
I want to say that to you guys forever and ever and ever. Yes, you. Mm-hmm. Yes, you. You are special and wonderful. I love doing random acts of kindness, like at the grocery store.
Yeah.
And it's weird stuff. Like if you just see somebody who's got a beautiful handbag, that's free. Tell them that's a beautiful handbag. Aren't you just delightful that you pick such a gorgeous handbag?
Yep.
Remind them that the world is a friendly and kind place.
Smiling at kids.
Smile at grown-ups too. I smile at kids and grown-ups to preserve the knowledge that the world is a friendly and beautiful place.
It's easy to start the habit with children.
It is. Easy to start the habit with children. But John knows I'm a long time random joy deliverer.
Yep.
Yeah. Like you won't catch me stopping the Starbucks pay it forward chain.
Oh no, we keep that on going.
Yeah. We'll start them too. I also like to do tall red ones. Just surprises. Just delight the world. Add the delight in the world. Add the delight.
And Elizabeth says Marion's doing a great job.
Oh, I am so glad. Thank you, Elizabeth. Because I'll tell you what, if I watch Marion, I stop painting. Because she's just so delightful to watch.
Yeah.
I'll be talking to her on a Skype, and it's just so delightful to watch. I'm like, it's so beautiful. I'm in a sippy sippy.
Okay, you sippy sippy. Everyone can sippy sippy.
Everyone can sippy sippy. Now I'm going to grab a detail brush. When I'm doing details, what I want is a small brush that gives me control. So I've got like a detail round here. I've got a small number 2 bright, and I've got a number 6 filbert. Now, I want to point out something interesting.
What's interesting?
Well, because even between these brushes, this is a number 6 filbert, right?
Maybe.
That's what it says.
Okay.
I'm going to find another number 6. This is a number 6 bright. Same brush line.
Cool.
Just saying that these are very, this is not a consistent sizing system.
No, I got a book at the art show.
Yes.
For one line. And what I have undercut.
Wasn't that for the ruby satin silver people?
That was. They gave me a real education in brushes.
Yeah.
They were really, really knowledgeable on the history of brushes and brush making. And
I just want everyone to know I put out some fluid paint. I am using golden. But listen, Artist Loft makes one as well. The difference between the golden and the artist loft is the golden will rarely ever be congealed.
Yeah, golden stuff is always good.
Yeah, it's, yeah.
So, but the people at the what was the name of the company?
Ruby Satin Silver.
Ruby Satin Silver.
So, I think it's silver brushes. Yeah. The ruby satins are the ones mom likes and, yeah, or something like that, yeah.
But man, they knew a lot about it. And ultimately, it comes down to that there was a European a metric brush size, and then an additional Japanese sizing.
So, and an American.
Well, Americans use the
imperial. So it's a whole thing. I think they just don't have any standardization.
Yeah.
We're going to put in some branches. You ready for branches, John? You can keep talking about brushes. I'm just going to put in some branches while we're talking brushes.
I am. I think that I'm not very knowledgeable on brushes.
I think, well, I mean, in that you've been to the place. Now, I like the fluid because I can just pull the paint out just straight. I've got it on my detail filbert here, which is a number 6. What's nice is you can overlay branches behind and in front of trees, and it creates a sense of space. I'm going to come over here, down here on the left-hand side, and I'm going to just take a little branch wandering up. Now, here's my branch tips. I press the hardest on the beginning of my stroke, and then as I move up the branch, I lighten, 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 lighten. And that's how I get it from the thick to thin. The fact that I'm using a well-crafted brush with a very tight filament, in other words, it's not loose and open and flared, and it's sharp, so it's precision, and then I'm using the fluid paint, absolutely helps me in all my brush branch construction.
No.
When I take any little branch off of it, I make sure my pressure is super light. And that each branch coming off is smaller than what it's attached to. And it's okay if the line breaks because your brain will finish the line. All right. Now I'm going to come over here. I feel like I want one up here coming off on the right. And it's going to wander behind.
Mm-hmm.
Its friend. And another thing that I'm going to do here, because it's a birch tree, is I'm going to flare out and pull a little black band out from the branch. That'll help make it feel attached too. See what I'm doing?
Yeah.
Give it that little birchiness.
Now, if you feel like you're struggling with some of your art supplies in the how it's covering,
mm-hmm.
Is that a good time to try to upgrade to a...
It is a good time. If the art supplies are making the painting hard, it's a good time to upgrade. And you can upgrade in stages. You can watch for sales. Everything goes on sale. Golden goes on sale for 40% off twice a year.
Yeah.
They have a cross, so like Dick Book, everybody, on sale twice a year. I don't think anyone's allowed to sell it below 40%, but you can find it for 40% off twice a year.
Coupons.
Coupons really help you. There's 50% off coupons for almost every store, so these things make a difference. I'm going to put another little branch coming up here.
Yeah, even if you have to buy your golden one tube at a time.
Yeah.
With your coupon. It's, you know,
you can do that.
It makes a difference, too, when you're painting with it.
You know, but and there's also stages. Like, you can, if you're, you know, if you've got an unknown brand of paint, right? You know, there's paints that are the next step up from that. There's, you know, you can get to the gallery acrylic. You can get to the System 3.
Yeah.
You can get to the Soho or the Lucas. You get that step up, right? And then when you're ready, you can very slowly. Artists have a mishmash.
But even that, your most basic acrylic paints work if you understand how to use them.
They do. And I think we're talking about, would you guys be interested in, I wanted to do maybe a series of going into, I feel like a lot of people, their only art store is Walmart.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's your experience, but I feel like a lot of people have the experience where there isn't maybe in their town a specialty art store. It's like online or it's Walmart. And I actually know how to make the paint at Walmart work.
Yeah. So we may do some lessons around that.
And show you how to make those paints work better for you. I'm going to come down here, and on the right, I'm going to make a little branch go up, and it's going to go in front of his friend. He's going to encroach. And I'm painting these in just black. I'm going to make a little branch here. So my pressure is just so light. But when I'm at the trunk, I'm pressing hard, and then this is a lot like eyeliner. I'm not kidding.
Yeah. So Flame Gremlin was complaining about creating moose antlers.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I hear ya. Let's see what I can say about that. That's helpful. All right.
Mooses don't grow on trees.
Mooses don't grow on trees. But then it's also our feeling about branches and the things. So the first thing I want you to do is get your smartphone out and pull up birch trees and look at the branches. Can't paint what you can't see. And if you're not looking at it, like I have a lot of branch information just fluttering around in my head. So it can give me a lot of like sort of like branch, hey, branch like this. But if you don't have that, you can get your smartphone out and look at some branches. And those branches can help you. Like, I'm going to come down a little bit and then say I take a right turn up. Say I broke that line.
Yeah.
That can feel very branchy because branches are affected by the world around them.
Pull your close-up camera up there.
All right. Look at these little branches. These little branches come in here and just, there you go. Just a little branch story. I mean, he needs a branch, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Come here. Let's put a branch on his little hip right here. It feels like it just desperately needs a branch. It's begging for a branch. Now, my branches on these tend to go up or slightly up into the side because they're reaching up towards the light. I might pull the band around here. Give it a little rough bit, like it would have. But never underestimate pulling up a good reference picture. That is one of the most powerful ways to help you break something. If you're just having trouble freehanding it in, you need a reference picture. That's all it is.
Mm-hmm.
Because you won't see everything, but you'll see more. Every time you use it, you'll see more. And then every time you go to it, you store more information about it in your brain. See, I'm just kind of weaving these out. Look at that. That's a very branchy branch.
Yeah.
Birds and things could land on that.
That's a squirrel branch.
That's a squirrel branch. Yeah, sometimes it helps. Imagine a squirrel chasing another squirrel up and down this forest. You know they do it.
Yep.
Having those little spring squirrel fights.
Yep.
Spring squirrel fight. I love spring squirrel fights. Little branch right here. Maybe this one goes back across the tree. You know, maybe just So I like branches.
So a lot of our community is saying that they think this is a very pretty painting.
I am so glad you guys are enjoying this painting. I really love it when you guys make paintings and you're proud of them. You post them on your social media. I see them on Facebook and I see them on Twitter. And you guys are like, I painted it. I'm like, oh, that's awesome. That's the best feeling in the world. Aren't these branches just looking happy?
They are.
They're just happy little branches. Bob was right. Everybody in the forest is happy.
Yeah. And we're going to give another little shout out to Tyler.
Hi, Tyler.
A little brush at home. He's a little under the weather today.
Oh, Tyler, feel better.
Feel
get
better.
Well.
Yep. Send some get well there.
Get well.
Paint.
I know there's another little brush that I've got to get well to. He's been just like sick.
We're going to send some love to all the little brushes.
Just bringing this little branch out in front of his friend. This layering things in front and behind helps create space in a canvas. When you take the time. Sometimes what you're seeing me do there is down here. Sometimes I make a little bumple here just to say that this isn't, you know, totally neat and perfect.
Yeah.
Because these guys have that little jutting. They have that little encrusting. That's what's happening.
No, we really like that other, in the other birch tree when you had the two that held hands.
Oh, isn't that wonderful?
That was really cool.
When you do that here, we can have some branches come here and talk to each other. Your branches, your trees can always be friends. Doesn't hurt. You can tell a story of friendship in your trees.
A little drama as they overlap.
This little branch is going to come over here and go behind its friend. It's cuddling. Saying it's okay. You're not alone in the forest. I'm here and I see you. Look at that. Little friend. They're being friendly. They're helping each other out. They're supporting.
Yeah.
Support is so important, isn't it? You know, we are creatures that need support, love, and kindness. We just do. We don't do well in the absence of it. Love, kindness. I'm just branching up because I want lots and lots and lots of stuff happening in the forest.
Mm-hmm.
Lots and lots of stuff happening in the forest. A little branch off here. Coming up. Just making sure. Goes off the canvas. There's lots of places for the leaves and things to hang. And that's what I'm creating is a believable structure in which some of this I'm painting I might paint out later. Might get painted out. Mm. I'm going to come over here. I feel like I'm looking for spots where I feel like, oh, that just needs a branch.
Got to send some hugs to Audie, too. I think that she's hanging out with her aunt.
Oh, hugs, Audie. Love, Audie.
Loved her.
All right, so I've got that in. Now, one little touch that you can do if you want. You don't have to. It's optional. If you've got some white fluid or you want to fluid out your white, you can just real quick, kind of like the trees that we had. John actually asked me to do this when I was designing this. He just wanted those branches to have a highlight so bad. Is think about the side of your branch that's facing the sun. And you can add a little highlight just on the outer edge to some of it.
Yeah.
As if the sun is catching. Not all of it. I'm just kissing some of it. See that?
Yeah.
Just a little highlight. And again, my trick is I don't try to hit every part of the branch. I'm not trying to outline. I'm trying to say a little light here and there is catching these branches. right? A little light. So the sun is here, which means like right here. Let's see if I can catch this. I'll show you what I'm doing right here.
You know, I'm learning right now in chat.
Uh-huh.
We have a very diverse hair color audience.
Do we?
Yes.
Good for you guys.
Lots of blues and purples and pinks.
Excellent. Excellent.
You have a people here.
All I'm saying is I paved the way back in the 80s for multicolored hair. I faced my mother when nobody had done it with purple hair, and she thought strawberry blonde hair was the most important hair color to ever be born with naturally, and I turned mine purple. So I paid my dues. I've earned these good pigments that they now have. I've earned them. Sorry. Just have some feelings. Just creating a little outline where I can. I don't want to disrupt what I've painted. I just want to highlight and maybe showcase some of what I've painted. The other thing is, the nice thing about this is this can help it feel like the layering of the branches by highlighting some of these. It'll make them feel like one is in front and one is behind.
Yeah.
Even increasing the entwining. But you'll notice I'm not... see, I stopped there to make sure that this branch feels behind.
Yeah.
All right. Little, just a little bit. Doesn't take a lot. You don't have to make yourself crazy. Don't go monk. Not the full monk. I love that show.
That was a great show.
It was just a wonderful show.
Yeah, there's a lot of hair dyeing and
yeah, I've got
color
a
stuff
hit
going on in there.
Hit with some radiant orchid this weekend. That's me. I'm radiant orchid and blood orange is what I'm into. And I'm just really lucky that I'm on the YouTube and I get away with it. The other moms, though, at the school are looking at me like I have lost my mind. I just grin at them.
But we have.
We have. It's totally fine. I'm like, that's fair. There we go. See, that was just super simple. It's just a little touch that you can do. Go ahead and hit them all. You know, just little kisses here and there. Not everything. Keep it light. Keep it thin. And if you're nervous about this, it's not necessary. It's just something you can do. Just something that you can do, right?
Yeah.
But you might not want to, and that's all right. Once I have that in, I get to get back into my rainbow space again. I'm going to get a number 6 filbert. My sippy sippy. Sippy sippy.
Yes. While you're sippy sipping, I'll say happy birthday to Donna.
Happy birthday, Donna.
Yeah. She's joining us today.
Hi, Donna.
You're not going to dip in your coffee there, are you?
No. No, because don't eat paint. Don't let me do it either. You guys
don't
catch me.
Paint.
Don't drink paint. Especially not cadmium. Don't do it. A huge mistake. Huge. So I'm going to get my paintbrush a little wet. I might need to put out a little more red for what I'm doing. All right. And I'm going to come here with my red, my cad red. I'm going to make some brush strokes. And they're going to be just straight up. Let's see if I can really get it down there and you guys can really see it.
Is that what you do with brushes?
Uh-huh.
Make brush strokes?
I do. That's what I like to do. I suppose you could do other things with brushes. I'm going to come right in front of my tree here with my red paint, brushing up some grass. We've been doing a lot of grass lately, so I feel like you guys are just totally ready for this. All right. And if you want, go ahead and get a little white. Add a couple little highlights in the reds that helps it show. All right.
Oh, yeah. That looks really nice.
Yeah. Fun stuff. I'm going to rinse out. I'm doing pure pigments across here. So the next thing, I'm going to get just pure orange. All right. I'm going to just come here with my pure orange. Some pure orange. Right across the bottom. These are some foresty grasses in rainbow. It's going to go a little bit into the yellow. And I feel like my red could have come over, so I'm going to grab a little and let these two blend together. See how I'm doing that? Little blend. See that on the up close? Okay, good. So, I'm going to rinse out. I'm going to rinse out, rinse out, rinse out. And I'm going to pick up just a little white. Get it into my orange. And just make sure I put some highlight of some sort of sherbet-y orange right there. I want my grass just to have a little highlight. Don't want to paint it all out, but I just want it to have a little highlight. Now I'm going to grab my yellow. Haven't rinsed my brush. Come back into my orange a little bit, and I'm pulling my yellow here. You hear the kids playing in the background.
Mona was just like, I can hear them playing.
You can, because they do all day. They're players.
Playing is a loose interpretation of Luna standing on the back of Honey, bouncing on her.
Yeah, I don't think Honey feels it's playing. When I go there, I'm going to get a little white. And I'm going to pull that white. Right? That's also going to help me cover over where that tree is and everything, okay? And I'm pulling it into my green space just a bit. Now, get your green. Just green. But my brush still has... I might need to put up more green. My brush still has a little yellow on it. I'm not going to worry about that too much. Because I want a little streakiness to all of this. And come here with my green.
Now
I'm going different directions.
If you're having streakiness problems with your paint.
Streakiness problems with paint can mean a lot of things. What are we specifically meaning?
Well, so Denise is having some problems with her Liquitex Basics.
Oh.
It's streaking horribly. Is she adding too much water?
It can be the almost. So here's my thing. When I go into the basics, I'm going to teach these things about student paints. I almost don't ever add water into student paint. Right? It's already as thin on pigment as it can be. All you could get from it is a glaze if you add any water. And as it is, I'm generally doing tricks or mixes to get it to feel more pigmented. So whenever I'm painting yellow, I'm going to add white to it. Whenever I'm painting blue, I'm going to add a little cad or sienna or dioxazine purple to it because these pigments are just too thin. So it's not that you can't get a great painting. You just have to think of it as almost a glaze. Right? So your trick will be to get the pigment load high enough for coverage, which is either do a several coats or kind of correct in the mix. And yeah, definitely, I know when I paint student paints, when I was painting parties, I didn't add any water to the paint.
Mm-hmm.
You know, where I didn't have to. Where I did not have to. Where no water was required. I'm going to add a little white to this green. Just to highlight those little bits there, a couple places. Now I'm going to get some blue. I'm going to let the white still be on my brush. I'm going to get this nice blue grass coming in here, painting out. And you think to yourself, but I worked so hard on the bottom of that tree. Yeah. Yeah, you did. That's art. All right. I'm over here, all the way to the edge here. And I'm going to put in my purple. I haven't rinsed my brush. So there's some streakiness to it. And it just gives me a nice result. And I can bring some back. And isn't that fun? I'm going to rinse out my brush. And I'm going to come up here. And I'm going to take a little white in my purple. Little white, purple. And I'm going to come up here in the upper right. And I'm going to dab a little bit of leaves. Now my trick to this is I leave it open. Can you guys see this really well? I might even zoom in on what I'm doing here. Right? It's open. It's very loose. right? You might end up painting out some of your branches. The trick to this, where you're going to get a result that you like, is to leave it open and not be too specific. You come down to the middle here, and these are dashes. I try to break up the space of where they're in. You know, we always talk about the Jackie Chan of it. I try to Jackie Chan it for sure.
Yep.
I got some blue here. I'm going to add a little white to it. Got some straight blue. Come in here. Maybe say that there's some more foliage at the top of this tree. Can you see the blue happening there?
I have to adjust your close-up a little bit more.
Okay. We're going to come through here.
Which brush are you using there?
I am using the number 6 Bright. Number 6 Bright. Just a little blue. And it's okay. I might even do a little blue and a little green here. And then a small amount of white to it. Just to make sure that I've got a nice blend between my trees. See that?
Yeah.
Just pulling here. Coming into the space, dabbing, but really looking to not overpaint it. Did I just put paint on my nose? That could happen. All right. Now I'm gonna wipe my brush, but not rinse it. I'm gonna get my green. All right. I'm gonna add a little white to my green, maybe a little yellow, because I want it to be very bright. All right. But it needs to show against the background. So if you need it, you know, you need it to be darker than your background, but bright enough to really feel like it's showing. See, I'm putting some there. You can make some of these dabs smaller. That's a thing that you can do to show this. Notice that I'm hardly putting any of these leaves on my branches.
Yeah, what's that about?
That's because I want people to really feel and see the branches. And they're going to imagine branches and leaves under. They're going to see it in their head.
Gotcha.
Now I'm going to rinse. Switch a brush if you have to. If you've got to switch it. And you're going to probably want to add some white to your yellow, a small amount of white to your yellow, just so it really pops. Come right here in the center and start telling that yellow story, these yellow leaves. You can kind of see how we're reversing the rainbow. All right, coming back with a rainbow across in the leaves and in the grass. But even though we're painting rainbow over rainbow, it's still showing, which is fascinating to me. Isn't it cool?
Yep.
Rainbow over rainbow. The trick will be recognizing when you got to rinse your brush out, when you don't. Now I might add some yellow back into that green, creating that blend. But I'd have to rinse my brush out after.
Yeah.
And we're almost through this, guys. We're almost done.
It's close.
We're really close to done. So just some pure yellow here. Maybe up here saying there's a canopy. I'm not seeing. Having fun with my dabs. Having fun. All right, having fun. Maybe put a little bit here. All right, now I'm going to get my orange. Mix a little into my yellow, but I'm going to get my orange. I'm going to come with my orange. My bright cad orange right here. See that? See how it pops?
Yeah.
Because the blending I did earlier, the slight tonal variance, my brights will really, 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 really show. I'm going to bring this here up over this trunk. I let the orange and some of these colors blend or fade into the space around them.
Yeah.
And now I'm going to get my just red, my cad red. I'm going to tell my cad red story right here. Pop, pop, pop. Because I toned this, it will show against its background.
Yeah.
And feel really powerful and wonderful. How do you guys love your rainbow birch trees?
They're
totally digging it out here. Everyone is saying how beautiful they love this.
I really love this painting. I was really happy to design it. I'm really happy to share it with you. I'm really happy to share my weekend with you. Let's all collectively breathe in the good of our week. Breathe out the bad. Thank you for taking time to put yourself on the list, to include yourself, to give yourself a chance to recover and recuperate, and just put down your burden for a minute. It's amazing how much lighter you can feel if you just put it down for a minute. You can pick it up again right after you're done, or not. That's up to you. But at least you've given yourself a break, a full mental, spiritual, relaxed break with your art. We are going to be back on Tuesday.
At least.
There's going to be some other videos that drop. They won't be live. They'll just be surprises of interesting things that are going on. And then Tuesday we'll be back. I'll post a poll on what we're painting on Tuesday on Twitter and Facebook.
Yep.
Because I forgot to put a poll here. I could put a poll here right after. I'll put a poll here too in an iCard. I'll come back.
You poll too much.
All right. I won't poll here. I'll poll on Facebook and Twitter. I don't poll too much.
Can you just do one? Can you just do Facebook?
You want me to just do Facebook?
I don't really care. I'm just giving you a hard time.
Oh. I think that when you say it, they're saying it. I'm like, I don't really care. I'm just making sure you can easily get to the poll. So your vote can be counted. So I'll put a couple choices of what we might do on
Everyone from Europe
Tuesday.
Will vote, but none of the Americans will. Okay.
I want to see you guys at the easel really soon. We love you. Thank you for your time. Thank you, Marion. Now I can look at her. Thank you, Marion. You did a great job. We appreciate it. We're going to see her again. In a couple of weeks, we're going to make arrangements to get back with her, and we're going to keep doing these lessons that have the American Sign Language. So
yes.
There'll be more. All right, I'm going to see you guys at the easel really
Love
soon.
Love you guys.
Bye-bye.